All right, children, to the assignment one, we'll first discuss question number two. That seems to be a bit typical. Question number two. As I read the question from the assignment, the minute hand. The minute hand of a clock. Minute hand of a clock is 7 centimeters long. Calculate the distance. Calculate the distance and displacement of the tip of the minute hand. Calculate the distance and displacement of the tip of the minute hand of the clock from 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Look at this diagram. This shows a clock, the red hand or the longer minute hand at 9 a.m. At 9 a.m., the minute hand is at 12. Look at the tip of the minute hand. It's at 12 mark. Okay. From 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. At 9:30 a.m., as you can see, 9:30 a.m., the minute hand covers half a circle and the tip of the minute hand, the red hand, reaches mark 6. So that means the minute hand at 9 a.m. is visible to you. The minute hand at 9:30 a.m. is also visible to you. Now to find out or calculate the total distance. To calculate the total distance that the tip of this minute hand covers, total distance that the tip of the minute hand covers. Well, total distance that the tip of the minute hand covers is, as you can see my spotlight, it is, see, half a circle. Half a circle, the boundary of half a circle, circumference half, which is half of 2 pi r. Remember circumference 2 pi r? This is half a circle. That means only pi r. Pi r, pi you know is 22 by 7 multiplied by radius. Now children, look here for this circle, and I am talking about the minute hand. So that means when this minute hand is covering a circular path, what is the radius for this circular path? For the minute hand is covering a circular path. The tip of the minute hand is going round a circle. Tip of the minute hand going round a circle. What should be the radius of that circle? The minute hand, its tip is going round a circle. The radius should be same as the length of the minute hand. Question is saying that minute hand of the clock is 7 centimeters long. That means radius is taken as 7 centimeters. Rest calculations are trivial, as you can see. 22 over 7. 22 by 7 multiply by 7 centimeters, that gives you 22 centimeters. So children, the total distance, look at my spotlight, total distance covered by the tip of the minute hand is 22 centimeters along this circular boundary. Okay, now next part of the question is calculate the displacement. How to calculate the displacement? I have already given you shorthand, shortcut to find displacement. Whenever ninth class, there is a question like calculate the displacement. How do you calculate displacement? Just look at what was the starting point. It started, the minute hand tip started from 12 mark, point A, starting point. Done. And this tip of the minute hand finally reaches mark 6. Or point B here, final point, starting point, final point, tip of the minute hand is clear. Now, when you calculate displacement, all you have to do is, kabhi bhi question is calculate displacement. Just join starting point to the final point with a straight line. This blue arrow, just join starting point to the final point with a straight line. This is displacement. This blue arrow tells you what is the displacement of the tip of the minute hand from 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. That means displacement of the tip of the minute hand is, it gets displaced by how many centimeters? It started from A. Finally, the tip is seen at B. So the tip is basically the position gets displaced by, what is this? This is actually double of the radius. Double of the radius means 14 centimeters towards south. Double of the radius displacement is 14 centimeters towards south direction. Please remember, whenever you are telling the distance covered, that gives, that means only 22 centimeters, total distance 22 centimeters is covered along the boundary. Okay, no direction is needed here. When you are telling distance, no direction is needed here. But when you are specifying displacement, there you must specify the direction. It says the position of the tip of the minute hand gets displaced. Position of the tip of the minute hand gets displaced from A finally to B by 14 centimeters towards south direction. All right? Towards south direction. This is how we can solve this particular question. Question number 3. A person is jogging around a rectangular park of dimensions, as you can see, 8 meters by 6 meters. Rectangular park, the person is jogging along the boundary of this park, 8 meters by 6 meter, twice. He went around the park twice, two times. Calculate his distance and displacement. Okay, distance, two times if he goes, total distance you can calculate. What is the total path length that he covers? 8 meters plus 6 meters plus 8 plus 6. 8 plus 6 plus 8 plus 6. What is the total distance covered? That is, in fact, the perimeter. You call this as perimeter. Two times here. So what should be the answer? 28 multiplied 2. This is 28 meters perimeter multiplied by 2. That gives you 56 meters. Total distance covered is 56 meters. Now B part. If suppose he goes 2.5 boundary, then calculate the total distance and displacement. So look here. There were two parts in this question. A part. A part was asking you to calculate the total distance he traveled. A part. If he goes two times if he is going and you have to calculate, two times he goes, you have to calculate the total distance that he covers. Total distance he covered should be 56 meters. That's it. But when he is asking you, what about displacement? Children, A part. How do you calculate total displacement? If this person suppose starts from A, he goes once full round around the park, then twice second round around the park, he comes back to A. That means two complete rounds back to A. Starting position, final position, both are same as A. So what should be the displacement? Obviously his position finally is not at all displaced. He is back to the same position. That means displacement should be 0 in my A part. Distance is 56 meters. Displacement is 0 meters. Now B part. 2.5 boundary he covers. 2.5 rounds he covers. If suppose he starts from A, one full round back to A, two full rounds back to A, 2.5. 2.5 means half round till C he has to go. Half round of the park. 2.5 means finally, final position should be C. Now tell me children, if final position is C, calculating total distance is simple. Distance means actual path length. Actual path length means if one complete round is 28 meters, so 28 multiply by 2.5. 28 multiplied 2.5 will give you the total actual path length, that is distance. But when you calculate the displacement, how do you calculate displacement? Just join the starting point to the final point with a straight line. स्टार्टिंग टू फाइनल टू एंड हाफ राउंड में स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ए होगा, टू एंड हाफ राउंड के एंड में फाइनल पॉइंट विल बी सी. इफ यू ज्वाइन ए एंड सी विद अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, दैट गिव्स यू डायगोनल ऑफ द रेक्टेंगल. दैट मीन्स इट्स टाइम टू कैलकुलेट द डायगोनल. आई होप यू कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट द डायगोनल. वेल, यू कैन यूज पाइथागोरस थ्योरम. Diagonal, the moment you join AC, children, you will be getting a right triangle. And in this right triangle, you can work out the hypotenuse. Use the Pythagoras theorem. We have earlier also talked about such calculations. Now, this one is for you to solve out. Calculate the diagonal. That will give you the displacement. And do not forget to mention the direction for displacement. A quick move to question number 4, second part, children. Look at this second part. It says you have to write the difference between distance and displacement. Now it is clear. Distance is total path length. Displacement is the shortest distance between starting to the final position. Displacement is the change in position of the object. Okay. Now speed and velocity. Remember last class we established the concept for velocity. Yes. Speed tells us how fast an object moves. However, velocity tells you how fast an object moves and in which direction is this object moving. When you tell direction also along with the speed, direction also along with the speed, it's called velocity. That means, as we did in last class, we established the two formulas also. Speed is calculated as distance upon time, but velocity is calculated as displacement upon time. Velocity is calculated as displacement upon time, right? Displacement upon time. Moving on to the next question now. Let's look at eighth question. Let's see if there is some problem with eighth question. Eighth question in this assignment is the odometer. I hope you know what is odometer of a car. In the car, there is a instrument that is fixed in, and this instrument called odometer measures the distance covered by the car. How many kilometers the car has covered so far? The odometer on the car's dashboard reads how many kilometer total distance that your car has covered so far. The odometer of the car reads 2000 kilometer at the start of a trip, right? And at the end of a trip, the odometer is reading 2400 kilometers. So that means it's clear during this particular trip, how many kilometers have been covered? 400 kilometers. Time is also given 8 hours. Total distance, you know, 400 kilometers. Time, you know, calculating the average speed. Total distance divided by total time. That is 400 kilometers divided by 8 hours. Of course, 50 kilometers per hour is the answer. 50 kilometers per hour is the answer. Now, we move to question number 10, children. This question number 10 is again a very, very good question. Question number 10, as you can see it on the screen, a body thrown vertically upwards. Imagine a body thrown vertically upwards. It reaches a maximum height of 20 meters. You can imagine a ball thrown up. It goes, say, a maximum height of 20 meters. It goes. Finally, it comes back to the throwers and it goes 20 meters. Okay, this is simple to imagine. A ball, you throw it up. Suppose it goes 20 meters up, goes, and finally it comes down back 20 meters. 20 meters up, then back 20 meters, obviously back to the thrower's hand. 20 meter is the distance covered upwards, and then when it comes back down, another 20 meters. Now, if the total distance for the whole journey is, total time for the whole journey is 6 seconds. Calculate the average speed and average velocity. Children, here, remember, average speed is given as total distance upon total time. Well, what is the total distance? The ball goes up 20 meters and it comes down 20 meters down. Total distance will be 40 meters. and total time 60 seconds. So 40 meter upon 60 seconds. Sorry, 6 seconds. 40 meter upon 6 seconds. Total distance 40 meter upon 6 seconds. But when the question is asking average velocity, formula says total displacement upon total time. How do you calculate total displacement upon total time? Total displacement. Displacement of the ball. The ball goes 20 meters up and then it comes back 20 meters down back to the thrower's hand. The ball is back to the same position. Finally, the ball is back to the thrower's hand. That means displacement is zero. Or average velocity should be zero upon 6 seconds. That gives you zero. Average velocity will be zero upon 6 or 0 meters per second. Now we have another very interesting question. This is our question number 12 now. As you can see this question number 12 on the screen. Question number 12 on the screen, as you can read, this question says the average time taken. This is a very interesting question, children. The average time taken by a normal person to react to an emergency is 1/15th of a second. 1/15th means 1/15 seconds. And this is called as reaction time. I hope you understand what is reaction time. It is the time taken to react by a normal human being. 1/15 seconds is our reaction time. Like any situation comes to you and you react to it. Your brain takes a decision in 1/15 seconds. Right? 1/15th of a second. Suppose there's a driver who is driving a bus at a speed of 90 kilometers per hour. 90 kilometers per hour ki speed per the bus is going, right? And if this driver suddenly sees there's a child running across the road. Now question is, how much distance would the bus have moved before he could press the brakes? I hope question is clear. How much distance the bus has moved before he could press the brakes? Before pressing the brakes, as the driver is driving the bus, he sees there is a child running across the road. He sees the message signal goes to brain. His brain reacts to the situation and gives a decision. It's time to press the brake. The time taken to think, take a decision that apply brakes, time taken is 1/15 seconds. Ab aapne calculate karna hai ki during this fraction of a second, ye jo 1/15 seconds jab tak brain soch hi raha hai, during this little time, bus to chalti chali ja rahi hai. What is the distance the bus covers during this time? We want to ascertain whether the child will be safe or not. Okay, speed. Speed is equal to, bus is moving at a speed 90 kilometers per hour. Children, look here. Yaha units are not consistent. Time is in seconds. The time taken to think. And during this time, is time ke dauran, bus is moving at a speed of 90 kilometers per hour. So, is speed se, what is the distance that your bus is going to cover during 1/15 seconds? Jitni der the driver is thinking, us dauran, 90 ki speed pe, what is the distance that the bus covers? Okay, 90 ki speed pe, the distance covered will be speed multiply time. This is the formula. But I have to check units. Time is 1/15 seconds. Speed is in kilometer per hour. I have to change kilometer per hour into meter per second. You know how to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second? Just multiply by 5/18. You get it in meter per second. Right? As you solve, you'll get 25 meters per second. Now you substitute. Speed is 25 meters per second of the bus. इस स्पीड पर बस इतने टाइम में, जब तक द ड्राइवर इज थिंकिंग व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस दैट द बस कवर्स, सॉल्व दिस आउट एंड यू गेट सी सेकंड्स एंड सेकंड्स विल गेट कैंसल्ड and you are left with meters, 5/3 meters, which is 1.67 in decimals. Imagine this distance, 1 meter, you know already, you can estimate. 1.67 meter the bus covers during the thinking time. Okay, question solved. Now this question has another part. Let's look at second part of the question, even more interesting. This second part for the question says, if the reaction time of the people, question, same question, second part, it says, you know that reaction time means the time taken to react for the people increases, reaction time bar jata hai when people are intoxicated. Intoxicated means when they have drunk, when the people are drunk, intoxicated. At that time, if you are mixing drinking and driving, then obviously when you are mixing drinking and driving, you are mixing drinking while driving, then this intoxicated condition, your brain will take more time to react. How much distance will the bus move if the reaction time of this driver was, if the reaction time of this driver was 1/5 of a second? 1/5 means 1/5 seconds. Denominator pehle 1/15 seconds tha, now it is 1/5. Denominator kam hua hai, that means fraction is increased, time bad gaya hai. He is taking more time to react. Now you have to tell, if this bus which was going at a speed 90 kilometer per hour, with this speed 90 kilometer per hour ki speed par, इस टाइम के दौरान, ड्यूरिंग विच द ड्राइवर वॉज थिंकिंग 1/5 seconds के दौरान, हाउ मच डिस्टेंस द बस कवर्स ड्यूरिंग ही थिंक्स. वेल, स्पीड 90 किलोमीटर पर आवर, वंस अगेन वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू मीटर्स पर सेकेंड, एंड देन डिस्टेंस स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई टाइम गिव्स यू 25 मीटर पर सेकेंड इज द स्पीड ऑफ द बस मल्टीप्लाई बाय द टाइम इंटरवल, जितनी देर तक द ड्राइवर थिंक्स 1/5 seconds, थिंक्स दैट आई हैव टू प्रेस द ब्रेक 1/5 seconds, solve this out. See, सोचने में ही the bus will cover 5 meter. Earlier it was just 1.67 meters. So your calculations clearly support the idea that we have to beware. We are not supposed to mix drinking with driving. That increases your reaction time. That means neither you would be safe nor your fellow people on the road will be safe. Right, now coming to another very precious question. This is a very interesting question of this assignment. This question which deals with the rabbit and the tortoise race. It's on the screen now. You can see this question on the screen. Here it comes. The question on the screen, here it comes. I read this question for you. A rabbit and a tortoise, they race each other. I hope this question reminds you of the playgroup time stories. A rabbit and the tortoise, they are racing with each other. Great, good. The rabbit, as you know the story, ran for 2 minutes at a speed of 7.5 kilometers per hour. Okay. Now this rabbit, he sleeps for 56 minutes. And suddenly he wakes up to know that tortoise has already crossed. After sleeping for 56 minutes, he again ran for the next 2 minutes at a speed 7.5 kilometers per hour. Question is, you have to find out the average speed of this rabbit in the race. How to calculate average speed? Before we come to the question, average speed you have to calculate. Well, average speed means it is the total distance upon total time. The working formula would be average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. Let's think about the first interval. Children, during the first interval or first 2 minutes of the race, this rabbit was moving at a speed of 7.5 kilometers per hour. 7.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर. दिस इज व्हाट द क्वेश्चन सेज. 7.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर की स्पीड पर दिस रैबिट वॉज रनिंग एट अ स्पीड 7.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर फॉर 2 मिनट्स. स्पीड इज गिवन, टाइम इज गिवन. विद दिस स्पीड ड्यूरिंग 2 मिनट्स हाउ मच डिस्टेंस विल ही कवर? वेल, ही इज मूविंग एट अ कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड. सो फॉर्मूला, स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई टाइम. प्रॉब्लम, 7.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर यूनिट्स आर नॉट कंसिस्टेंट. लुक हियर, स्पीड है किलोमीटर पर आवर में, टाइम इज इन मिनट्स में. यू हैव टू बी कंसिस्टेंट. सी कंसिस्टेंट यूनिट्स. द इजिएस्ट वे शुड बी इफ आई कन्वर्ट मिनट्स इंटू आवर. हाउ डू यू कन्वर्ट मिनट्स इंटू आवर चिल्ड्रन? मिनट्स इंटू आवर डिवाइड बाय 60. सो यू गेट 2/60 आवर. नाउ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई टाइम. आई गेट 0.25 किलोमीटर्स. Okay, that means 1/4 of a kilometer. 0.25 is the answer during the first 2 minutes of the race. After first 2 minutes, next 56 minutes, next 56 minutes, the rabbit slept. So average speed should be, the rabbit slept. So does he cover any distance? No, he covers a total distance of, he covers a total distance of 0 kilometers. Okay, let's move on. After 0 kilometers, the last 2 minutes of the question. The last 2 minutes, the next interval, the rabbit is covering a the rabbit is moving at a speed of, the rabbit is moving at a speed of 7.5 kilometers per hour once again. As you can see it on the screen. 7.5 kilometer. Okay, back to the screen. 7.5 kilometer per hour is the speed. And for the 2 minutes, once again, check units. Are they consistent? Kilometer per hour. And this is 2 minutes. Hour here, here, minutes. No, they are not consistent. Convert minutes into hour. How do you convert minutes into hour? Divide by 60. So you get 2/60 hour. Speed multiply time. You get 7.5 kilometer per hour multiply by 2/60 hour. Solve this. You get another 0.25 kilometers. Another 2.5. Another 0.25. 0.25 kilometers. That means what is the total distance that this rabbit covers? Total distance. First interval he covers 0.25 kilometers. And the second interval, he was sleeping. And the third interval, 0.25 kilometers. Total, 0.50 kilometers. 0.50 kilometers. And what was the total time of the race? 2 minutes, then 2 minutes, and then 56 minutes. 2 minutes, then 56 minutes, and then 2 minutes. Total minutes is how many? 60 minutes. Total time is 60 minutes. So done. Total distance, you know. Total time, you know, 60 minutes. I convert this into R so that when I calculate speed, total distance 0.50 kilometers divided by total time will give me 0.50 kilometer per hour. 0.5 kilometer per hour. Children, the thing to be noticed here, what is the average speed of this rabbit? Average speed of this rabbit for the whole journey is just 0.50 kilometer, 0.5. Imagine 0.5 kilometer per hour means half kilometer per hour. Puri journey ka average speed nikal ke aaya half kilometer, only 0.5 kilometer per hour. Compare it. During the first 2 minutes, what was the speed? 7.5 kilometer per hour. Jabki overall journey ki average speed is just 0.5 kilometer per hour. So that means average speed gives you an overall idea that the total distance of the whole journey in how many minutes or in how much time is it covering? It's giving you the overall idea. What was the overall speed of the average speed for the whole journey? However, the speed during the first 2 minutes was quite high for this rabbit. 7.5 kilometers per hour. Compare this with the average speed of whole journey of the rabbit. 0.5 kilometers per hour. Right. So that means this is how we'll solve this particular question. We'll try out another question now. This is little typical question, so please pay attention. Now on the screen, as you can see, is question number 13. On the screen, I'm reading out this question. Anand leaves his house at 8:30 a.m. for his school. Okay, 8:30 he leaves his house. School is 2 kilometers away, distance he has to cover. And classes start at 9 a.m. Right? 9 a.m. and from home he leaves at 8:30 a.m. That means he has to reach school by 9 a.m. That means half an hour. He has 30 minutes time, or total distance is 2 kilometers he has to cover. Right? Now question is, if this Anand, he walks, if Anand walks at a speed of 3 kilometers per hour, at this speed, 3 kilometers per hour for the first kilometer, for the first kilometer, 2 kilometers total tha, then at what speed should he walk the second kilometer to reach just in time? Just in time means total time he should take is 30 minutes. First kilometer of his journey, he is going at this speed. You have to tell me, what about the next kilometer? Jo second kilometer tha, what should be the speed? How should he make up his speed? Abhi dekho, first kilometer only 3 kilometers per hour ki speed par. So next kilometer, what should be the speed so that he just reaches in time? This is how you go about with this question, children. The total distance he covers is 2 kilometers, right? Time taken is 30 minutes for covering the first kilometer. For covering the first kilometers, as you can see, for covering the first kilometer, speed is 3 kilometers per hour. Okay, first kilometer, pehle kilometer mein distance pata hai, speed pata hai, distance and speed. We can calculate what is the time he takes. What is the time he takes? Obviously, the formula goes distance upon time. 1 kilometer distance. In 1 kilometer distance at a speed of 3 kilometers per hour. That means 1 kilometer divides by 3 kilometers per hour. This gives you 1/3 hour. 1/3 hour. Aap soch ke dekho, 1 ghante ka one third of an hour. How many minutes? 1 ghante ko 1/3. 3 equal parts mein divide karo, you get 20 minutes. 20 minutes lag rahe hain. That means first kilometer he covers in 20 minutes. Uske paas total time hai 30 minutes ka. That means remaining, how many minutes are left with him? Only 10 minutes. 10 minutes ke andar ab usko, that means he has to increase his speed. For covering the next kilometer, he has only 10 minutes. Next kilometer, only 10 minutes. Well, if you convert minutes into hour, you get 1/6 hour. So speed should be distance upon time. Distance is 1 kilometer, next kilometer. Or next kilometer mein time kitna hai? 1/6 hour. 1 divided 1/6 gives you 6 kilometers per hour. Obviously, 10 minutes mein cover up karna hai. So 6 kilometers per hour should be the speed during the second kilometers. 6 kilometers per hour should be the speed during second.